Welcome to my world. Good afternoon, guys, and I really mean good afternoon because it is 5 o'clock in the afternoon. But let me tell you something. One of two things, okay? One thing is, I figured out why I haven't been sleeping well. It is Benny. Every morning I wake up with him with his foot on my face, with all sorts of shit. Like, he's scratching himself. He wakes me up. He doesn't let me sleep. Like, I wake up and I'll be like, Benny, stop. And then he'll stop and then he'll do it again. So then today Emma took him off the bed while I was sleeping and I slept like a baby. And I actually woke up refreshed. Number two, today's one of those days which happens very rarely in life. Very rarely. It's one of those days that you look at life in like a different way, that you look at life and you're like, wow, life is so beautiful. I love life. I love it. I'm so happy to be alive. Everything's so perfect. You're motivated. You're happy. You just feel great. And I'm having one of those days, which is awesome. Because yesterday I was having a day that I was like bored. I was like, what do I do? I was disgusted by the day for some weird reason. And then Freddie took down my fans. And then Freddie did all this. And then the day just turned around, and I guess I got so occupied with so much shit that we were doing that, you know, it ended up being like an interesting day. But I didn't even feel like filming yesterday, and thanks to CJ, he actually kept pushing me to do it. I did it, and I'm actually pretty proud of the product that we have so far. So anyways, let's see what I do today. Probably gonna chill, maybe jump in the pool. Yesterday I was supposed to, but I didn't. And well, I wasn't supposed to. You're not supposed to do anything in life. But I wanted to, and I didn't. So let's see what I do today.
So I'm on my way to La Madre's, and it is so freaking hot. It is. It says it's 91. This poor guy is going nuts. Oh, man. The gate is not working right. Let me go fix that. So today is my brother-in-law, Lynette's birthday. I will not disclose how old he is because I don't think he wants everyone to know. Haha. And we have a message for him. Happy birthday!
Lynette!
Miss you, love you.
Miss you, love you.
What's up, guys? I wanted to stop really quick and talk to you guys about something weird. I felt bad because I had a random visitor come over. He's a good friend of mine. He came over to my house, and it seems like these are like the tragic stories that you hear about. He's a business owner. It's kind of ironic because he's a business owner and he owned a lot of like companies and stuff like that. He makes a lot of money. Man, he came over here and he told me that he's addicted to drugs. He's lost like 5 companies. And it was, I can't explain it. Like, I felt, it actually healed me a little bit because I'm always worried. I don't know if I've ever told you guys, but I'm always worried about like my health since I smoke cigarettes and stuff and I've been trying to quit. I'm always like worried about those kind of things because I want to live as much as possible. I don't want to die. But I saw him and, you know, the way he was acting, the way his, you know, facial expressions, how he was feeling, and I felt so like bad for him. And I was like, man, I was trying to give him advice. I mean, I didn't even know what to tell him because I didn't know. It was just such a weird, like, a circumstance that presented itself because I hadn't seen him in over a year, and he shows up and then, you know, he has this problem in his hands. I just want to know if you guys have like any ideas on how you guys think I can help him, because he's addicted to certain drugs, and you know, and he's a good friend of mine. We don't speak that often, but he came to visit me randomly after like a year that I haven't seen him, and I just felt really bad because when I saw him, he wasn't the same and he looked really bad. So if you guys have any advice on that, let me know. All right, guys, I honestly don't know what I would do without this thing reversing like that with the little camera this car has. Because for some reason, the little passageway in the back of my house is so difficult to back out of. It's like really, really hard to back out of this little thing. I'm surprised Emma does it so well. She's gotten used to it. But since I haven't been driving for a long time, I've lost my touch. Anyways, guys, it feels pretty good to go out and about. I'm on my way now to go get myself my chocolate milk because I cannot go to sleep without my milk. And it just feels good to be able to drive, to be able to like go places. Finally, you know, since I got my license and all that, I feel great. It's an awesome, awesome feeling. You know, so guys, I will be heading to CVS and you guys will see me there. I get my vitamin D milk. And oh, they have it right here for me. It's like they were ready. And what else do I need? Emma wanted some iced tea. There's her iced tea right there. Alright guys, it's obviously not very easy to vlog when you have your hands full like this. This is ridiculous, but whatever. I wanted to show you guys a different scenery. My CVS by my house. This is what it is all about. As usual, Emma has outdone herself again with some delicious steak and rice. Love it. I like sometimes keeping things simple, I just like eating like just rice and a meat, and that's it. Alright guys, I've had a long day today. It hasn't shown too much, but I'm really, really tired. I don't know if you guys can tell by my eyes. I have to wake up tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning. It's 4 o'clock in the morning now. So, well, not tomorrow, today. I have to wake up in literally 6 hours. And I am exhausted. I have a meeting tomorrow with my business manager. Hopefully everything goes well. Crossing my fingers. Guys, again, I can't tell you how much I'm grateful to the fans that I have. And how much you guys support me. I love you guys so much. You guys, I feel that with you guys are going to get me to the top. And you guys are going to get me to where I need to make it, man. I have a big dream. I have a huge dream in this life, and I finally made a decision to go for it and forget about money and forget about all the other things this world likes to corrupt people with. I'm not trying to say money's not good, because money is awesome, but you know, money is in a way the root to all evil, because if you're making money, you forget what really makes you happy. And unless you're making money with what makes you happy, which is what was the opposite of what's happening to me. But anyways, I feel every time I'm talking to this little flip, it's amazing, it's a little flip cam, but I feel like I'm talking to people. It feels so good to know that I'm just recording this, but tomorrow I'll have response and people will be talking back to me from this little camera that I'm recording. You guys are going to respond back to me. It's such a good feeling. I love you guys so much. Oops, I stepped on one of Benny's toys. Good night, guys. Take care. Sweet dreams. I hope your weekend was a blast. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.
It's Chase Haber, the Miami vlogger.